How many calendars are there? It turns out, just one, and it's calculators of 1974. I mean, come on, if you had a calendar with this in it, why on earth would you ever need any other calendar? I mean, look at that. Aww. In that case, I'm gonna look specifically at how many calendars there are in the Gregorian calendar date-keeping system. And of course, throughout history, different countries and cultures have had their own calendars, and that continues to this very day. If you get a phone and you look at the calendar setting, I'm now recording this at the very end of 2018, 2019 comes next. But if I go over into my general settings, not date and time, but under that languages and region, I can change the calendar. So let's go Buddhist. And now, all of a sudden, if we come back out to the calendar, it's the year 2561. Maybe borrow a friend's phone, change the calendar, and then try to convince them they've just woken up from a coma. Even though there are other calendars, the Gregorian calendar is the one used by most countries, and it's the one that the official ISO date keeping standards are based upon. So I'm going to look at the Gregorian calendar and see how many of those there are. 14. That's the answer. There are 14 different options. We should have started with that. Sorry, wow. Classic YouTube. We got there eventually. Could have just started watching here, it turns out. So there are only 7 different days that the year can start with, and it's either a leap year or it's not. That's it. 14 options. Every single year is one of those. So 2019 starts on a Tuesday, not a leap year. 2020 starts on a Wednesday, is a leap year. 14. Because 2019 starts on a Tuesday and is not a leap year, you can use any calendar from any other year which started on a Tuesday and wasn't a leap year, including 1985, which is why I went and bought the Culture Club calendar from 1985. And this was, that is peak 80s right there. And that's not even a joke, right? This is not like someone making fun of the 80s later. This was made in 1984. This was done deadly seriously. And in the interest of balance, I didn't just buy the Culture Club. I also got the Scorpions. There we are. More 1980s, but in a very different fashion. That's pretty 80s. Oh, that's very 80s. Oh, look at that, right? So these start on a Tuesday, not leap years. And so I can use them. I actually bought these in 2012 because 2013 started on a Tuesday. It wasn't a leap year. So these were my calendars from 2013. And now I can reuse them in 2019. And likewise, 2020, find any calendar which started on a Wednesday and was a leap year, use it again. Confession time, the calculators in 1974, I made this myself because I thought I was hilarious. It's my own calculator calendar made for my own personal use. But 1974 also started on a Tuesday and wasn't a leap year. So I thought it'd be very funny to make a calendar which is based on 1974 but works in 2019. And the other problem with 2020 is because it's a leap year, those calendars are a bit more rare. They don't come up as often. So you need to go back to 1992 if you want to get yourself a 2020 calendar. I mean, that's pretty rad. And then you can save it until you get to 2048. It's the next time it will be used, because 2048 is as far from 2020 as 1992 is. Not rad. And when I was making my calculators of 1974 calendar, I did the actual like month grid myself. I generated these in Excel and I couldn't be bothered changing the length depending on the month. I thought it'd be funnier to have a set 7x5 grid, and then I put a 1 on whatever day in the week the month happens to start on, and then it just fills in the rest of it. So you can see here, March will start on a Friday, here it starts on a Monday, right? But then here I've propagated all the way through to 35. You've got to know when to turn over to the next page. And a lot of them, if they start later in the week, where's one that's later in the week? Here we go. This one doesn't start till Saturday, and so I put 0 and negative, so you can actually turn the page over early if you want, start using the negative numbers of the next month. And that made me realize that every single month, there's only 7 options for each month, well, apart from February. So February can have 2 different lengths, and it can have 7 different starting dates, so it gets 14 again. But otherwise, every single month only has 7 options for that specific month. Across all months, 7 starting points. There are 4 different lengths of a month. There are only 28 different possible months, which makes things like this make me very angry. Good luck, everyone. This year, December has 5 Mondays, 5 Saturdays, and 5 Sundays. This happens once every 823 years. No, it doesn't. These things online really annoy me. I get the argument they're just some harmless fun, but honestly, get a calendar and check. You can look up the months where this happens. All months that have more than 28 days will have 5 occurrences of a particular day within them. And all the months that are 31 days long, like December, is always gonna have 3 days. I don't know why they changed the order here, but Saturday, Sunday, Monday, if it starts on the Saturday, you're gonna have a bonus Saturday, Sunday, Monday on the end. That's gonna happen every single time, but yet this stuff gets passed around. And actually, if you want some good ammunition for the next time you're annoyed by something like this on the internet, we can have a look at how long it takes a Gregorian calendar to loop completely. If you take my list from before of the types of year and set it going, eventually it will loop. It will perfectly repeat itself. I actually made this list in Excel. Putting in the formula to work out leap years is kind of fun, because if the years are multiple of 4, it is a leap year. Unless it's a multiple of 100, then it's not. Unless it's a multiple of 400, and then it is again. And that means that the leap year system in the Gregorian calendar repeats every 400 years. And because 400 years worth of days, it's 400 times 365 plus the extra 97 leap days, that total is a multiple of 7, the days repeat at exactly the same time that the leap years do. And so every 400 years, the Gregorian calendar perfectly loops back on itself. So the day you're enjoying now is the same as the day 400 years ago and 400 years from now. 2019 is a Tuesday non-leap year, as was 1619, as will 2419. Although I appreciate there are some complications because, like, in different countries, they switch calendars at different times. So if you go back into a different calendar system, so in England, in 1752, they switched calendar systems, took out 13 days, but didn't change the order of the days. So that breaks that going backwards. And who knows what's gonna change going forwards. But for now, on this calendar system, nothing can happen less frequently than every 400 days. That's the longest you can go for any weird combination of days and dates that you want. It'll repeat at worst every 400 days. It cannot be every 823 years. I have no idea where that number originally came from. If anyone can find out and tell me where 823 years comes from, I would love to hear it. Although none of this factors in cultural or religious or personal days. And some people are thinking, well, hang on, generic religious holiday, that moves around. That doesn't loop every 400 years. You can't say calendars repeat every 400 years. Those dates don't. And the thing is, that changes for everyone. So when I made calculators of 1974, I thought, you know what? I'm gonna fill in all the days that are important to me. And so on the 31st of December 18, which is the zeroth, I turn 20 million minutes old. So that is my 2 times 10 to the 7 minute birthday. Straight after Christmas, which you'll note I haven't bothered putting in, straight after that on the 26th, that is my 2000 day wedding anniversary. And that's probably worth noting because my wife and I celebrate every multiple of 500 days because that makes more sense. And I better not forget that. That's a very important day that myself and Lucy celebrate. And I would say there are probably as many different ways to celebrate personal and special days in the calendar as there are people celebrating those days. And so the calendar itself repeats every 400 years, but you can choose how every year is unique and special to you. And I hope you have a very fantastic, unique, and unnecessarily nerdy new year. Fun fact, while this is something I made for my own personal use, and so you cannot buy it or give it to anyone for Christmas, you can give them my new book, Humble Pie. Hear me out, like, I'd really appreciate this, because if you order it, we have a bonus gift we will actually give you two of the chapters now and a certificate saying you bought it for someone so you can give it to them before Christmas. The book itself doesn't come out until the 7th of March 2019. Oh, I better mark that in. The 7th of March 2019. However, if you want to give it as a gift, it's a bit lame to say you're going to get some generic book at a random date in the future. Here we go. Thursday, Humble Pie Day. So this way you can give them the certificate. It says they're going to get the full thing. They can get two chapters right now as an ebook so they can start reading. They don't have to wait until Humble Pie Day the following year. But on that date, they will actually get the book. And if you order it through Mass Gear, it'll be a first edition hardback signed one by me. If you order it through Amazon, you can still get the free gift. I'll put a link to the website that Penguin have very kindly made for me. So if you go there and put in your confirmation number, you get all the extra bonus stuff now, and then Amazon will ship it in the new year. I mean, Amazon is cheaper on Amazon, but if you get it from me, I sign it and I pay my taxes. There you go. Just get it for everyone you know. That would be amazing, and I really appreciate that. That, I mean, or of course, go and get them 1985's Culture Club calendar for a whole year of this much 80s.